Hello dear friends, welcome to the world of mathematics. It's me Srija Suresh and you are watching SS Math Solutions. In this video, I am sharing how to calculate compound interest with a trick. That is application of Pascal's triangle. Okay? Firstly, we can check how to write our Pascal's triangle. Okay? So we are starting from 1. Okay? Then we will put 1, 1. This is a triangle shape, Pascal's triangle. Then, every time 1 will come in the first. Then we will, for the third row, first row 1, second row 2 ones. Okay. Then the third row, 1, then 1 plus 1 is 2, triangle shape. Okay. Again, 1. Now in the fourth row, again 1 will come. 1 plus 2 is 3, 2. 1 plus 2, 3, 2 plus 1, 3, again 1. Okay. Then in the fifth row, again 1 will come here. 1 plus 3 is 4, 3 plus 3 is 6, 3 plus 1 is 4, 1, etc. Like this will go. We want, for this compound interest, we need like this. Okay, these numbers. That is, we need to remember these three rows. For 2 year calculations, compound interest for 2 years, we will take this 2:1 ratio. For compound interest for 3 years, we will take 3:3:1. For compound interest for 4 years, we will take the numbers 4, 6, 4, 1. Like this. These are the numbers we need to remember for calculating compound and compound interest annually. Let's check our questions. We can try compound interest questions with the help of Pascal's triangle. Okay. Our actual methods, you know that it is 2 length by applying the formula, which is that formula P into 1 plus R by 100 the whole raised to N. This is a 2 lengthy formula. P is the principal amount, R is the rate of interest, and N is the number of years. But by applying this very easy, we can calculate within 2 minutes or within 1 minute. But if you know the calculation very quickly by practicing, then we can calculate this compound interest within 1 minute. Okay, let's check how to calculate the compound interest with the help of Pascal's triangle. Here is our question. Find the compound interest on 1400 at 10% per annum for 2 years compounded annually. I wrote this Pascal's triangle's application number. So when you will get a question, firstly you check for how many years. Here 2 years. So our ratio is for 2 years 2:1, 3 years 3:3:1, 4 years like this. So we need 2 years. So 2:1 we will take firstly. So 2:1. Then find the compound interest on 1400. So 1400 10%. What is that 1400 10%? 140. So this 140 we will write here. Okay. Then 140 we got from 1400 10%. Then this is compound interest, means interest on interest. Right. So firstly we got one interest 140. Then again we need to take interest on interest, means 140 is interest. So 140 is 10% we will find. Okay. That is 14 you got. So 1 into 14. This much only. So we calculate here 2 into 140 means 280 plus 40. 280 plus 14 means 294. This is our answer. Okay, hope you understood. So we will take our Pascal's triangles, that is first row 2 years. Then firstly 1400 10%, very easy. 140 we got, interest on interest. Okay, so compound interest means interest on interest. So 140 is interest we will write here. 140 is 10%, that is 14. So 2 into 140 280, 1 into 14 14, we will add this both, we got 294. Very easy. Hope you understood. Let's check one more example. Our next question is here. Find the compound interest on ₹7,500 at 4% per annum for 2 years compounded annually. Here it's also 2 years. So our ratio is 2:1. So we are writing 2:1 here. Now we need two numbers. So 7,500 for 4% we need firstly. So what is 7,500 4% means this 275 into 4. 300 will come. So 300 plus again interest on interest. So 300 is 4%. So 300 4% means 3 into 4, 12. 2 into 3, 6. So 600 plus 12 is 612 is the answer. Very easy. Hope you understood. So 2 years means 2:1 will take here. Firstly, amounts 4% calculate here. Then next step, interest on interest means firstly we got one interest, then we apply this 4% for that interest. Then we will write here multiply sum. Finished. Hope you understood. Let's check one more example. Here is our next question. Find the compound interest on ₹8,000 at 5% per annum for 3 years compounded annually. So here our years 3 years. So we will take this is for 2 years, this is for 3 years. So we will take this. So our numbers are 3, 3, 1. Then 8,000 5% for 3 years. So firstly we will take for 8,000 into 5/100. That is 8,000 into 5/100. Two zeros will go. Then 8 into 5 is 40. 10. So 400 will come here. Plus again 400 is 5%. So 400 into 5/100. That is 4 5s are 20. Plus again one more is here for 3 years. So 20 is 5%. So 20 is 5% is 1, right? 5 tens are 10. So 10 by 10 is 1 will come. So 1 into 1. Every time interest on interest, that remember, okay? 400, 8,000 is 5%. 400 is 5%. 20 is 5%. 3 into 400, 1,200. 3 into 20, 60 plus 1. So we'll get 1200 plus 60 means 1260 plus 1. So 1261 is the answer. This is the interest. Then if they will ask what is the amount after 3 years means, we will cut this 8000 plus 1261. That is the amount after 3 years. This is the percentage compound interest only this one. If they will ask the question, what is the amount after 3 years means this compound interest plus 8000 we will calculate. Okay, hope you understood. Try to answer these two questions and comment below. Find the compound interest on 12000 at 7% per annum for 2 years compounded annually. First question. Then one more question. Find the compound interest on 6,000 at 2% per annum for 3 years compounded annually. Hope you understood today's video. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe my channel for future videos.